Something very special is going to happen on the evening of December 7th this year. The moon will be full, and both the moon and the planet Mars, which we've highlighted here, will be rising around sunset and be bright all night long. This shows the sky at around 5 o'clock when it's not yet dark, but let's speed up time a little bit. As the moon orbits the Earth, its path is going to carry it right in front of the planet Mars. Mars will disappear behind from the moon for about an hour and then reappear. Now, when the moon blocks the sun like that, it's called an eclipse. But when the moon blocks a star or a planet, it's known as a lunar occultation. The little video you just saw was made using a computer program called Stellarium. And here we're using Stellarium to show the moon at the point where it's just starting to cover up Mars. That will be early evening, around 6:35 p.m. Pacific time. The timing is going to vary depending on where you are, and I'm going to talk about that in just a little bit. I want to mention that there was a lunar occultation of Venus some years ago. I was with some summer campers, and they all pointed at the moon and said, "The moon has a pimple, the moon has a pimple." And golly, that's just what the moon looked like. I wonder if this December 7th, the moon will look like it has a pimple. If you're in Berkeley, or really anywhere in this part of California, the moon will pop out from behind the moon at 7:36 in the evening. This map, which I found at inthesky.org, shows where people will be able to observe the lunar occultation. And it includes a lot of the continental United States, except for the east and southeast and Alaska. It includes almost all of Canada, Greenland, and Western Europe. And we'll take another look at this in a little bit. But let's check out what people will see in Anchorage, Alaska. In Anchorage, the path that Mars seems to take relative to the moon will just graze the edge of the moon. It won't be an occultation, but it could still be fun to watch. And now let's look south of the occultation band at what you would see in Laredo, Texas. In Laredo, Texas, the path that Mars seems to take relative to the moon will graze the moon on the other side. And again, it's not an occultation, but it could be fun to watch. And in Berkeley, the path that Mars seems to take relative to the moon will carry Mars right almost through the center of the moon behind the moon. So this is a great place in California to observe this occultation. The moon and Mars will be different in different places because of the way the moon and the Earth and Mars line up. Now, let's pretend that you are Mars and I'm a person here on Earth, and this globe of the moon will be the moon for us. And as the moon orbits the Earth, now I can't see you, now I can. That was an occultation. But if I'm farther south as the moon passes by, it doesn't block my view of you. Or if I'm farther north as the moon passes by, it doesn't block my view. So that's why occultations happen only in a band across the face of the Earth and not everywhere on Earth. Let's take another look at this occultation band. If you're too far to the west, the occultation will be happening before the moon and Mars have even risen. So out here in the Pacific Ocean, you won't see it. In this funny region, the occultation will be happening as the moon and Mars are rising. In California, the moon and Mars will be well risen and we'll see it in the early evening. In this part of the world, the occultation will be happening around midnight. Over here, it will be happening in the early morning after midnight. And if you notice that this map says December 8th, that's because after midnight, it's the next day. The day after that we see it on December 7th in the United States. And then over here, the occultation is happening as the moon and Mars are setting. And over here, the moon and Mars will have already set while that occultation is happening, and you won't see it over that part of the world. This picture of Mars peeking out from behind the moon is a computer simulation made with Stellarium, but I imagine a lot of astrophotographers, people who take pictures with telescopes and cameras, will be trying to get a picture like this. But you don't have to fuss with cameras or telescopes to enjoy this lunar occultation of Mars. Just go out in the evening of December 7th and see it for yourself.